When we have so much on our plate right now, environmental concerns can fall in the too hard basket.
So, as the COP26 summit draws to a close, we went in search of some achievable steps we can take to help the planet. Some of them might surprise you.
This week, our planet's most passionate protectors gathered. The message is clear. The time to turn the tide on climate change is now.
Get in line or get out of the way.
Many of us are already doing our bit, but there's always more we can do. Like deleting our old emails and photos. All those computers that run our cloud storage use almost as much energy as the airline industry. Flicking the switch to electric wherever possible. Dad's petrol leaf blower is worse for the planet than even the biggest oversized man truck. And encourage and support those with responsible packaging and practices. But we know that sometimes it can all feel a little bit too much. So how do we tackle this on home turf?
A dairy farmer and environmentalist Stu Muir is here now. Great to talk to you, Stu. Now, saving the planet's a big call. How can all of us make a difference?
Kia ora, kia ora. Look, we can all make a difference, whether it's individually or collectively. You know, if you're living in the cities, get yourself a rat trap, give one to the neighbour, you know, poison those rats. If you're planting trees, you know, plant things that are actually bearing fruit, that have got flowers. If you've got a big lawn or even a small lawn, just leave part of it alone. Let the biodiversity thrive. If we got rid of all of the pests in our forests, it would be the equivalent of removing 60% of our transport industry's greenhouse gases, just by the regrowth in our forests and by getting rid of the methane of all those possums, deer, goats, pigs, ferrets, cats, you name it, you know.
Stu, we often hear agriculture getting a bad rap. What are you seeing on the ground?
I'm seeing a lot of change, Jeremy. There's, like, take the Mokau, for example, if you're heading down to New Plymouth. All the way along there, those streams that were, you know, 10 years ago weren't fenced off, now they're fenced off, creating these amazing biodiversity corridors. You know, there's great plantings through there. The water is improving here. Got a long way to go, but there's so many groups up and down this amazing motu of ours that are doing these sort of community biodiversity and regeneration projects. So I'm actually greatly heartened looking into the future.
What's the most surprising thing about climate change that you've come across?
Oh, there's so many things, Hilary. I think one of the best things is the ripple effect. You know, you take this Waikato River here behind me. I started a pest control program down here, and initially it was just me. People thought I was a little bit nuts, probably, trying to eradicate all the pests on the islands. But once it actually resonates with the local community, everyone jumps on board. Now we've got over 2,000 bait stations on all of these islands up and down the river. Our natural plant life's coming back. We've got kereru, we've got tui, the ducks are coming back, and the trees. And that's probably one of the most heartening things, is to see how communities get in behind little projects that end up becoming quite big projects.
We've got some big targets to meet, Stu. What's your one piece of advice to Kiwis?
Don't be overwhelmed. You know, we can all make changes. You know, if you're a fisherman, don't catch the limit, limit your catch. If you're a diver and you see barren rocks, you know, because a kinna, remove as many kinna as you can. If you're in town, plant, you know, plants that actually will increase our biodiversity, you know. Doesn't matter how big or how small our changes are, they all make a difference if we act collectively.
Thanks, Stu. You make a lot of sense. Appreciate your time.
Kia ora, kia ora. Pai ana.
And emails, iCloud storage, photos, killing the planet. Never, ever thought about that before.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, look, so many double-ups. So many double-ups on you. You think about all your photos, six photos of your kids doing exactly the same things. You've got to delete those photos.
But it seems so personal to delete a photo of people you love.
I know.
It's so lethal.
But hold on.
Nasty.
No, you still keep one, but you don't need the six of exactly the same thing. And then, of course, here's a little top tip. Then you print them out, put them into what they used to call photo albums, family photos, and then you can look through them whenever you want.
I love photo albums, but I've left it so many years. I haven't put anything in a photo album for about the last 6 or 7 years, so there are thousands of photos. The job is too big. When we had our first lockdown last year, I thought I would do it. I didn't.
That's a full-time job.
I didn't.
Yeah, that's tough.